We thank you for this day, this celebration. Darling Son Jesus came to dwell among us. We thank you, God, for the gift of life. Now, God, we are continuing with our worship experience by getting into your word, and we thank you, God. Speak now to your people that we may hear what you're saying to the churches, even today, even to us as individuals. Thank you, God. These are all blessings we ask in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
The Gospel of John, the 4th chapter. So we thank God for our young people.
Amen.
And that powerful presentation from Sister Hunt. John chapter 4, let's look at verse 7. As we stand on our feet for the reading of God's word. You'll find these words recorded. There cometh a woman of Samaria to draw water. Jesus said unto her, give me to drink. For his disciples were gone away unto the city to buy meat. Then saith the woman of Samaria unto him, how is it that you, being a Jew, ask drink of me, which I'm a woman of Samaria? For the Jews have no dealings with the Samaritans. Jesus answered and said unto her, if you knew the gift of God, and who it is that saith to thee, give me to drink, you would have asked of him, and he would have given thee living water. May God add a blessing to the reading of his word. Jesus answered and said unto her, if you knew the gift.
Yeah.
I'd like to speak into your hearing from the subject, the gift.
Amen.
The gift. In our text this morning, Jesus is leaving Judea, and he is on his way once again to Galilee. Bible records that he had to go through Samaria.
Amen.
The disciples did not know why Jesus needed to go through Samaria, but Jesus knew. So he came to a town in Samaria named Sychar, near the plot of ground that Jacob had given to his son Joseph. Jacob's well was there, and Jesus, tired as he was from the journey, sat down by the well. And it was about noon. For John in 3:16 says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. That whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Then there's more. John 3:17 says, for God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved.
Amen.
So we begin this morning looking at primarily three chapters of life that we all find ourselves unable to escape or avoid. First chapter is your story. We all have a story. Your story might be a little different from mine. None of us have the exact same story, but we all have a story. So there we see that The gift seeks you. End the story. The gift seeks you. Instead of taking the normal Jewish route around Samaria, because the Jews didn't even like going through Samaria. Samaria was, you know, that part of the region where the religious folks in those days, the chosen people, didn't like to venture through. Amen? There are some parts in town where some of us can become so holy that we don't want to venture to. Amen? The Jews hated the Samaritans because they were half-breed Jews whose ancestors intermarried with Gentiles during the Assyrian captivity. Amen? The Jews considered them unclean traitors, unclean to the nation, and unclean to their God. Therefore, they would not even walk through their land. However, Jesus said he needs to go through Samaria because there is a woman there that he must meet. Jesus wants to meet her because she is the reason he came to earth. Can I get a witness? Watch this now. This unnamed woman is actually seeking Jesus, but she doesn't know it. So she's looking for love in all the wrong places. Because Jesus is love. Amen? You know what I mean this morning?
Yes.
Amen.
Yes, yes.
So about noon, Jesus arrives at Sychar, a town in Samaria. Isn't it amazing that Jesus knows, amen, exactly where you're going to be? And he knows exactly where he wants to meet you. Can I get a witness? You thought that maybe it was just by coincidence that even that you're here today. But you have been positioned by God, amen, so that God can meet you, amen, because he's seeking you. In the midst of your story, he already knows all about your story. And thanks be to God that that doesn't stop him from seeking us. Because some of us, once we know other people's story, you know, we can either choose not to want to be around them anymore, like the Samaritans. Yeah. But thanks be to God that Jesus is not like the Jews. Jesus is not like how some religious folks can be. Can I get a witness? Jesus seeks you in spite of yourself. He already knows all about you. Can I get a witness? And you may be thinking that you're just going on along your merry way and along your merry life, and all of a sudden there is Jesus sitting at the well. Can I get a witness? Waiting for you to get there because he already knew that you was going to show up at noon at Sychar that day. So Jesus arrives in Sychar, a town in Samaria. He's tired from 2 days of walking. He sits down by Jacob's well, just outside the city. Even though Jesus is God incarnate, he is also fully human. And he shares the same exhaustion as everyone who has walked for 2 days. Can I get a witness? His disciples go into town to buy food. While they are gone, this thirsty Samaritan woman, carries a water pot on her head as she comes to the well. Because of the hot Palestinian sun, women normally came to the well at dawn or at dusk when it was cool. But this woman comes at noon, the hottest time of the day. In August, some of you don't even come out of your house here in St. Petersburg at noon. Can I get a witness? Because you know that the sun is normally at its highest point at noon. It's too hot. But she doesn't want to be taunted by the other women who want nothing to do with her. She would not be welcome at any synagogue, her story. She is welcome, however, in the presence of the Son of God. We can give God praise right there. That in the midst of our story, Jesus showed up. Can I get a witness? That's what we're celebrating today, that in the midst of our story, he showed up. Because our story without Jesus means we was on the road to destruction. We was traveling on the broad way. Can I get a witness? The way that leadeth to destruction. But I'm so glad that Jesus, amen, sought me enough to love me enough to show up, amen, knowing I'm coming at noon. Because there comes a time in our story where we feel so alone, amen, because of the imperfections that we know we have in life. This unnamed thirsty Samaritan woman is not the only person, amen, in the region who has made a mistake. But for some reason, amen, her mistake is glaring. Can I get a witness? And you know, the perfect people call her everything but a child of God. Call her everything, amen, but someone who is in need of Jesus. How could the religious people, can I get a witness, who were, if the truth be told, imperfect themselves, amen, how could they know more about this woman's business than about their own? But because, can I get a witness, that now she is seeking something that she doesn't know what she's seeking, Jesus is able to step in, amen, and step into her path and be sitting on the well when she came with the pot on her head at noon. She's by herself. Because sin will leave you by yourself. Can I get a witness? The devil comes, amen, before sin comes. But when sin, amen, has completed its work in you, it leaves you by yourself. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
Oh, I need somebody who can bear witness to that. That, you know, because of the way I was living, I had to maybe avoid some people. Because of the way I was living, I maybe didn't even want to return to church anymore. Because of the way I was living. But I'm so glad that we have a Jesus who knows that he needs to go through Samaria. Because you see, Samaria is where I was. Can I get a witness? I wasn't in Judea and I wasn't in Galilee. I was somewhere in between. Can I get a witness? I had one foot, amen, in trying to do right. And I had another foot in just the devil having his way with me. I was somewhere in between. But I'm so glad that I serve a God who doesn't mind going in between. You don't want to go all around the situation, can I get a witness? Because you don't want to be exposed to the sin of other people. But Jesus came into this land, into this world, to save the sin sick.
Yeah.
He said, I didn't come to condemn them. I came to save them. Because this woman is in bondage. Anytime you got to travel alone and try to get water at the heat of the day to avoid the busybodies. Can I get a witness? She's looking for something. And some of us was looking for something, but we didn't know exactly what it was. So we looked for it in all the wrong places. Can I get a witness? Help me, Holy Ghost. Jesus is waiting for her at the well to give her a gift. Remove from your story to your season. Because during the season, the gift draws you. The gift draws you. The woman thought that she was going to Jacob's well because she needed physical water. But in fact, she had an appointment with the Son of God. In the same way, no one is listening So me preach this morning by accident.
All right.
You have an appointment with Jesus. He has something to say to you, and is already waiting for you with this lesson. Can I get somebody up in here to give God the praise for your appointment? You didn't even know you had an appointment. Can I get a witness? Look at the person next to you and say, you have an appointment. And you're going to keep this appointment. Can I get a witness? You don't have to put this appointment on your calendar. You don't have to put it in your iPhone. You don't have to put it on your reminder list. Amen. God has set the appointment. And he's not going to ask you to come, amen, to find him. He is going to find you. Oh, I wish I had a little help in here. Somebody know he found me. She stopped acting like you made the appointment and you kept the appointment. He found you. Because if he had not found you, you would have continued to go to the well at noon, amen, with living water. With bottled water, but not living water.
Yeah.
All right.
Since he doesn't have a bucket or a jar,
all right.
Jesus says to this Samaritan woman, give me something to drink.
Yes.
But she defensively responds, how is it that you being a Jew asking me for something to drink? I am a woman of Samaria. For the Jews have no dealings with the Samaritans. Jesus says to this astonished woman, if you knew the gift of God, if you knew the gift of God, somebody say the gift, you would have said to me, give me the drink. And he would have given thee living water. The woman turned to Jesus, the well is deep. And since you have no container from which to draw water, she asked, where will he get this living water? Jesus tells her, look, people who drink from this well will thirst again. Then he says, but whosoever drinketh of the water that I'm going to get shall never thirst again.
Yes.
But the water that I shall give him shall be in him a well of water springing up unto everlasting life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. So whosoever believeth in him should have. Look at somebody say, I know what the gift is, but I'm beginning to see it a little clearly now. I know what the gift is, but it's beginning to come a little more clearly now. Can I get over this? I was expecting something else. Help me, Holy Ghost. You know how it is sometime when on Christmas Day you're expecting something else. What if one of you opened up your present, amen, on Christmas morning and it was a bottle of water? Help me, Holy Ghost. You know, seen all those big commercials on TV with the young people. They got their minds on all this stuff, amen. What if you, they got one gift under the tree, and it's a bottle of water. Amen. My kids would have, you know, my kids, are, they were intellectual, they would have called a meeting. I'm not sure what's going on with Dad. Did I take a little strange lady? Did you get a bottle of water too? Yes, I got a bottle of water. What's Dad thinking? Amen? But it's your season. And when it's your season, can I get a witness? When it's your time, Jesus will show up. I need somebody in here to declare that it's my season. And when he found me, it was my season.
Yes.
I was on my way to hell, sinking deep in sin, so far from the peaceful shore, but the master of the sea,
yes,
he heard my despair and cry. Can I get a water? Can I get a minute? And out of the waters, amen, he lifted me.
Yes.
I'm so glad that he drew me. Can I get a witness?
Uh-huh.
I thought that I was just going along my regular way. But Jesus, amen, drew me.
Yes.
And he said, if I be lifted up from the earth, I'll draw all men.
Yes.
Me. Why do we continually drink water? Because we keep getting thirsty. The water from David's well would only temporarily quench the woman's thirst.
Yes.
Not only does the water Jesus offer quench our thirst so that we will never thirst again, but it will also be a perpetual well inside of us that gives us eternal life. The woman doesn't know exactly what Jesus is talking about. Therefore, she said, how am I going to draw water for you? I know you don't want to use my drawing spoon. Can I get a witness? Because it's a little used. It's got my germs on it. And some of y'all, you know how y'all do. You wouldn't drink after certain people, even sometimes your parents taught you.
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
But I don't mind drinking after Jesus.
All right.
And he don't mind drinking after me. He came for my germs.
Yes.
He came for my germs.
Yes.
He didn't mind my germs. My germs did not scare him. My germs drew him.
Yes.
My filthy ways, amen, did not scare him.
Yes.
My frivolous ways, sometimes our evil ways, our wicked ways, amen, did not scare him. It did not cause him to go around us, amen. He came for your germs. If you would just give your germs to the Lord,
yes,
he will give you the gift,
yes,
that keeps on giving.
Yes.
Can I get a witness?
Yes.
But Jesus is going to shock her even more. As we move from your story to your season,
yes,
to your Savior.
Yes.
See, in your season, in your story, the gift seeks you.
Yes.
In your season, the gifts draws you. In your Savior, the gift saves you. Watch this. First he confronts her. Then he forgives her. The woman doesn't understand what Jesus means by living water, but she wants a changed life. However, though she doesn't yet know, she must first confront her sin. Jesus tells her, go get your husband. Now, wait a minute, you mean just having a conversation about the well, the water, the well? Like, what you know about me? You know, like, now, come on now, you know how it is when the preacher gets on your street. Can I get a witness? Use web, use some water, but you don't understand. In order to get the gift, you must confront your sins. We need to know him and the pardoning of our sins. Jesus tells her to go get your husband. Why? Because he wants her to consider her sin and her need for repentance and forgiveness. And the Bible says, who he has forgiven much, much will have, those people will have a greater praise. Can I get a witness? If the Lord has forgiven you of a lot of things, amen, and you know that it was God who forgave you and didn't condemn you, amen, but saved you, amen, you can really have the greater praise on your lips. Some of us seem to forget sometimes exactly what God did for you and how he delivered you, amen,
yes,
how he took your sins and nailed them to the cross. Can want her to consider her sin. Watch this. Jesus came to save her, but he has to die first. Jesus said, I'm sorry I haven't made man, but I will redeem man back to myself. It cost God the precious blood of his only begotten son. The greatest gift in history had no servants, but they called him master. The gift had no degrees, but they called him teacher. The gift had no medicines, but they called him healer. The gift had no army, but even kings feared him. The gift won no military battles, but he conquered the world. The gift committed no crime, but they crucified him. The gift was buried in a tomb, but the gift lives today. The gift had a name. His name is Jesus. And he paid the price for you and for me. So that we could have life after our appointment. Look at somebody that says there's life after the appointment. The angel said unto her, fear not, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you shall conceive in your womb and bring forth a son and shall call his name Jesus. And the Bible declares that there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flocks by night. Can you witness? And lo, the angels of the Lord came upon them. And the Bible declares that the glory of the Lord shone round about them. And they were so afraid. And the angel said unto them, fear not. For behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people, which shall be to the Judeans, to the Samaritans, to the Galileans, can I get a witness? To the Zionites, to the drugites, to the alcoholites, to the whorites, can I get a witness? To the sinrites, help me, Holy Ghost, to the drunk right, to the high right. It's for all of the right because it makes you get right. Can I get a witness? And you shall, unto you is born this day in the city of David, a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you, you shall find the baby wrapped in swaddling clothes. And the Bible says, and suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, glory to God in the highest. And on earth, peace and goodwill toward men. How many know that his name is Jesus? He is the Emmanuel. He is the gift that is with us. He paid the price for you and for me. Yes, you need to go home and tell the world, come see a man who told me everything that I did, but still loved me in the midst of my situation. I'm so glad that God loves us even in the midst of our situation. That he knows our story, yet he came to save us. He came to deliver us. He came that we might have a right to the tree of life. I wish I had somebody here who knew how valuable the gift is. It's the gift that keeps on giving. It's the gift that keeps on blessing. I tell you, my brothers and sisters, if the Lord has ever done anything for you, you ought to tell somebody he has made a way out of nowhere. You ought to tell somebody that he has been a burden bearer. You ought to tell somebody that come see a man. My testimony is my testimony. And your testimony is your testimony. If the Lord has been a heavy load bearer, somebody say, thank you, Lord. If the Lord has been a
redeemer. The Lord says something. We are the people that have been redeemed from the hand of the enemy. We are the people who have been redeemed. That's the redeemer. The Lord says something. Come on, y'all. You put a praise on your lips. You put a song in your mouth. You put clapping in your hands. You put shouting in your spirit. He opened up blinded eyes. I'm talking about Jesus, the one who came to save us, the one who came to deliver us. He said, Daddy, make me a body, and I'll redeem man back to you. Now, 42 floors. The womb of the Virgin called Mary. He stepped into the lobby and came to save me. And I'm so glad. They whipped the gift. They spat on the gift. They put an old rugged cross on the brow of the gift. But when you got a gift, you got to open it. And he said, if they open me, my blood, it goes pour out. If they open me, if they unwrap me,